myself. Why get up? Why get up? Why get up? How can I get up? Why should I get up? This whole world's gone crazy. Think I've seen enough. I'm gonna sleep forever. Why get up? Went to the doctor. He said to lose some weight.
Hello.
Good morning.
I'm Gale.
I'm sorry I couldn't make it last night.
That's all right.
No, I wanted to, Lynn. I really did.
Forget about it.
So how'd it go? I want all the details. Don't leave anything out. Oh, hold on. This whole world's gone crazy. Think I've seen enough. I'm gonna sleep forever. Why get up? Sorry, business. So come on, tell me who showed up.
Nobody.
Nobody? You mean like the people who did show up were to you nobody?
No, I mean nobody.
You mean not anybody?
That's right. That's all right. I mean, I'm fine. I was able to catch up on some work, and then I zenned out on this report, and by the time I know this adorable had it wrong, it's like 2 a.m.
Not a one?
I wasn't in the mood to be around people last night anyway, really.
Yellow.
Hi, Frank.
I just spoke to Linda.
Yeah, I got a caller. I didn't make it to her party last night. I wanted to, but it was impossible. I was swamped.
Tell me about it. I couldn't make it either, and that's not the half of it. Linda told me that Jerry never showed either.
Oh. That's too bad. Was Barbara disappointed?
Are you kidding? Barbara was probably too busy to be disappointed.
It never stops.
Hello?
Hi, Jerry. What's up?
I'm inundated.
I hear you didn't show up at the party last night.
What can I say? I was drowning, and by the time I looked at my watch, you know, I did warn you that there was only a 50-50 chance I'd make it. I did warn you of that fact.
It's just that Gale really wanted you to meet Barbara. You know Gale.
No.
No, but I've told you all about her. I've told her all about you. Then she got into wanting to set you and Barbara up, and it's become practically a crusade for her. Anyway, she thinks that you're perfect for Barbara and vice versa. Well, Gale should know.
Why?
Because I told her all about you. I've mentioned you to her I don't know how many times. And she told me all about Barbara. They're old friends. They go way back. They're like us.
Hello.
Hi, Barbara. So, where were you?
I'm sorry. I've been working on some very tough multiple deadlines.
Look, Barbara, I was really disappointed that you didn't make it. I really want you to meet Jerry. I really think you guys would hit it off. Let me set you up, please.
I don't know.
You'll like each other.
You will. Trust me. What have you got to lose?
What about us? I mean, when are we going to get together? We haven't seen each other in I don't know how long.
I thought you were going to be at the party. Look, why don't we have lunch? You, me, Frank, and Jerry. What do you say?
I don't know.
I'm not going to take no for an answer. 12:30, Garucci's. I'll make the reservations.
How about 1:15?
1:15 it is.
Hello.
We're meeting for lunch, 1:15, Garucci's.
We?
You, me, Gale, and Barbara.
But...
I'm not letting you out of this.
But...
I'll see you then.
Frank? Frank?
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Who's this?
Who's this?
Martin.
Martin Wiener?
Yeah.
Wrong number.
Hello?
Hello.
Who is this?
Denise DeVorio. My father died when I was 7. My mother was an alcoholic. We never got along. I'm kind of shy, in some ways I'm a little bit, you know, aggressive. I like to read current biographies, though. Are you Jewish? Wiener. That's usually... Jewish.
Why?
Just curious.
I'm sorry, but I don't give that kind of information out over the phone.
Why not?
Because... I don't.
Why?
Because I don't know who you are, okay? What are you doing?
You're mad at me.
No, please. Okay, I'm Jewish, okay? I'm Jewish.
Martin.
Yeah?
Is it all right if I call you Marty?
I guess so.
You can call me Denny. Are you funny?
Excuse me?
God, didn't you ever notice how many Jewish comedians are? I mean, I don't think I'm stereotyping.
Do I know you?
No. Then, well, yes. In a sense.
What?
Don't be mad at me, Marty. Promise me you won't be mad.
What are you talking about? Mad at what? Well, why should I be mad?
Well, I'll tell you, but only if you promise you won't get angry at me. I mean, that little voice you make, it's just...
I promise.
I know something I'm not supposed to know, Marty, and it's about you.
Hey, what the heck is going on?
Hey, you're angry at me. You told me you wouldn't be. Our relationship is brand new, Marty. Brand new and already broken promises.
Martin?
Oh, Jerry, hi.
Do you have a minute? I'm a bit discombobulated.
Yeah, I know the feeling.
This ex-girlfriend of a friend of mine is trying to set me up with a friend of hers, and they all arranged to meet at this restaurant at the last minute. I didn't show.
Why not?
I would have. I was up to my ears.
Hey, it happens. Just call and explain. I'm sure they'll understand.
I don't know. I'm so embarrassed even to call my friend. It's Frank. You remember Frank?
No.
Didn't you meet him? I thought you did. Maybe not. Hold on. Hello?
Jerry.
Speaking.
Hi, this is Gale Donnelly, Frank's ex-girlfriend.
Oh, hi. Could you hold on? Martin, it's her. It's the woman who's trying to set me up. What do I do? I don't know what to say.
Lie. Tell her you sincerely wanted to make it and that you were on your way there, but you got stuck in traffic and you had to turn back. And your car phone was out or you would have called.
Gale?
Jerry.
Look, I'm sorry I didn't make it. I got held up in traffic and had to turn around and, you know, my car phone wasn't working. And when I got back, I realized I didn't have Barbara's number or, you know, I definitely would have called her back and apologized.
Well, why don't I just give you Barbara's number right now? That way you can call her yourself. I'm sure she'll understand.
Right.
It's 555-3832.
Got that? 555-3832.
555-3832.
Tell her I said hello. Bye.
Bye. Martin?
Jerry,
I don't believe this. She gave me Barbara's number. I'm obligated to call her. I don't believe this. I'm not ready for a relationship. I'm so overburdened work-wise. I don't have a second to think half the time.
Hello?
Hi, Frank. It's Gail. I just spoke to Jerry.
Now, why did you do that? I told you I was going to speak with him.
Because I felt terrible, and I wanted to apologize personally for not being able to make it. But then, get this, Jerry didn't make it either.
God. Well, what did he say when he found out that none of us made it either, not even Barbara?
He didn't say anything because he doesn't know.
What?
Well, that's why I'm calling you. I don't want Jerry to find out. That way, he'll feel guilty and he'll have to call Barbara.
What?
Then I spoke to Barbara and I told her to say that the three of us got together and we were waiting and waiting, but Jerry never showed.
Are you crazy? Why on earth would you want to do that?
Because I want these two to get together. I think they're a perfect couple. I think they're a couple made in heaven. And I hold on. Hello?
I can't believe I agreed to this!
Barbara.
Hold on. Hello?
Barbara?
Yes.
This is Jerry. Jerry Heckerman?
Hi. I'm on another call. Hold on. Oh my God, it's him. What do I do?
Talk to him.
Please. Please don't make me. I don't even know what he looks like.
So what? You talk to people every day. You don't know what they look like.
Yes, but this is different. I mean, this isn't business. This is a blind date. Once I had a blind date 11 years ago. My mother set us up. He had a very intense stare.
But I bet he turned out to be a very nice guy, right?
He tried to rape me.
Barbara.
I'm not kidding.
Where is he now? Is he still holding?
Oh, my God.
Hold on. I'll be right back.
Don't. Where are you going? I need you.
Relax, will you? Get a grip. I'll be right back, I promise. Frank?
Yeah, what's going on?
Do you have a picture of Jerry?
What for?
I'll explain later. Do you or don't you?
Well, I'm not sure.
Well, I don't understand. You said he was your best friend. How can you not have a picture of your best friend?
We haven't had a lot of time to socialize lately, so... Well, I have a picture of him from when we went to school together. Well,
circle his face!
I got it.
And?
He's cute.
She likes it.
Jerry?
Just sitting here by myself, so sad, lonesome since my baby left. She's gone and I'm going home. I hate to be alone.
Hi, Jerry. Frank, we waited and waited for you the other day. What happened? Call me.
Hi, this is Gail. I spoke to Barbara, and she said you two got disconnected. And she couldn't call you back because she doesn't have your number. And I told her that you didn't call her back because you probably misplaced her number. I know that I'm right about this, right? Right. So here's her number again. 555-3832. Call her. Don't be a schmuck.
Hi, this is Barbara. We got disconnected earlier, and I didn't have your number, so I called Gale and she gave it to me. Oh, sorry you got stuck in traffic the other day. We were all waiting, though not that long or anything. I mean, I wasn't at all inconvenienced or anything. I mean, it didn't matter. It would have been nice to meet you, but anyhow, hope to hear from you whenever.
Hello?
Barbara?
Hello?
I just hung up on Jerry.
What?
I can't believe it.
But why?
I was on the toilet.
So? I always take calls when I'm on the toilet.
So do I, usually, but those are business calls or people I know well, feel comfortable with. This is different. It didn't feel right. I mean, what if he asked me what I was doing?
Why would he ask? Anyway, if he did, just tell him you're lying in bed in a red silk teddy licking a lollipop.
I could never.
Hello?
It's Jerry. Did I wake you? I know it's late.
No, I'm just sitting on the john. What's up?
That girl Barbara called. Left a message on my machine. So I called her back and she hung up on me. I think. I mean, you know, we may have just gotten disconnected.
What do you mean? Which one was it?
It sounded like she hung up on me. Then why would she leave a message on my machine telling her to call her? Just so she could hang up on me? I mean, I wouldn't want to call her back if she hung up on me. On the other hand, if it was a accidental disconnection, I wouldn't, you know, necessarily be adverse to trying again.
Hello?
Frank Oliver?
Yeah?
Hi, my name's Martin Wiener. I'm a friend of Jerry's. I hope I'm not bothering you.
No, not at all. Jerry's mentioned you. What can I do for you, Martin?
It's about this Barbara that your ex has been trying to fix him up with.
Yeah, what about her?
Jerry doesn't know I'm calling you. He just wanted to forget about it. But, well, there appears to have been some confusion, and I'm wondering if you could help clear it up for him?
I'll do my best.
It's like this. Jerry just tried to call Barbara, and he's not sure if she hung up on him or if they were just disconnected. If they were disconnected, he'd be happy to call her back. But if she hung up on him, well, you know Jerry.
Yeah. He's got a fragile ego. Hold on one second, Martin. Hello?
Frank?
Gale?
We've got a problem. Jerry just called Barbara, and she was so flustered that she hung up on him, and now she's too embarrassed to call him back. We've got to get Jerry to call her back again.
Martin?
Frank?
Tell Jerry that Barbara thinks he hung up on her.
Jerry?
Speaking.
Hello?
Yeah?
He felt awful. Martin practically had to talk him out of suicide.
And?
He's going to call her. Either that or jump off a bridge. I hope we did the right thing.
Yes?
He's calling you back. Don't blow it. Call me after you talk to him.
Yes, she's gone. She says she wants to be free. Please don't tell her what has happened to me. She's gone. So I'm going on back home. I hate to be alone.
Hello?
Marty?
Denise?
I'm not trying to obligate you in any way. I mean, that's in no way my intention. I want to be very clear on that.
All right.
Okay, this isn't about obligations.
All right.
Hello?
It's Martin.
Hi, how are you?
Overwhelmed.
So what else is new?
No, I mean in my personal life.
What's the matter?
Well, I did this thing a while ago. I didn't tell anybody about it, not a soul, and then I just forgot about it. I put it out of my mind like it never happened.
Martin, you're frightening me.
I read this article. It was about these women, and they're not married, they're not in a relationship, and they're really busy, and their biological clocks are ticking, you know? So they go to these places, and I went out and donated sperm.
Really?
I don't know what came over me.
I think I read that article. Was that in Newsweek?
But then, now, the recipient? Never even occurred to me, a recipient. I mean, if I just paused for a second to consider it, I would have realized it's part of the equation, you know? Donor, recipient. Anyway, she called me up. Denise, that's her name, the recipient. And she's pregnant with my child.
No kidding. Gee, I thought those things were anonymous.
Usually they are. She knows somebody that works in the bank. He gave her my name.
Is that ethical?
Oh, they're old friends. They went to high school together.
They had a thing, apparently.
Hmm.
I just donated one sample. One lousy sample.
So, what, she want child support?
No.
She just wanted to thank me, that's all. For making her life complete.
And what'd you say?
You're welcome.
All right.
I didn't know what else to say.
What else could you say?
I don't know.
Your welcome was good.
Then there was this long silence. We just listened to each other's breathing. Then she gave me her number and she said if I ever wanted to, I should call her and we could get together.
And what'd you say?
Thank you very much, but I don't think so.
Nothing wrong with being honest.
Except I was lying. I do think so. I want to meet her, Jerry. I truly want to meet her.
Then do it.
Oh, I can't.
Why?
Oh, I'm so besieged lately. I've never been this besieged.
You can't make any time.
Well, sure, some time, maybe. Then what? I mean, what if we get involved? Suddenly, I'll have all this responsibility on my shoulders.
Everything I've ever worked for, all my plans could just go up in smoke.
Do I sound like I'm rationalizing?
You're certainly running the real risk that once you meet, a more than simply impersonal relationship could develop. I mean, you know, that's...
She's almost 8 months pregnant. 8 months pregnant with my child.
Wow. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Is it a boy or a girl?
Hmm? What?
The baby, is it a boy or a girl?
Oh, I don't know.
They know these things very early now. She must have an idea.
Hello?
Denny?
Marty.
How are you?
I'm all right. How are you?
You're sewing?
Just a little. So is that the only reason you called?
No.
Are you calling because you want to get together?
No.
Oh.
But I do.
You do?
Only not right now.
Oh.
I'm deluged. I've never been this deluged.
Oh, I understand.
But I will, eventually. I'm gonna do some juggling, and eventually I'll make some time. We'll get together for sure, okay?
You don't have to if you don't want to, Marty.
No, but I do.
Whatever.
Denny? Is it a boy or a girl?
I don't know.
Oh. You know, they know that kind of thing early nowadays.
Oh, my doctor knows.
He does?
Yeah, but I want it to be a surprise. I like surprises.
Oh.
If you want to know the gender, Marty, I can find out for you.
Oh, no, it's not necessary.
No, it's no problem. I could call the doctor. I could have to tell you. It's just, you have to promise not to tell me. I mean, even if I change my mind, no matter how much I insist on knowing, you just must never tell me. I made my doctor swear. You have to swear, too.
All right.
On your mother.
All right.
Cross your heart and may you burn for eternity in hell should you break it.
All right.
Hello?
Jerry?
Speaking.
This is Barbara.
You know Gail's friend? The Gail who's the ex of your friend Frank?
Oh. Hi, how are you?
All right.
Right. I'm sorry.
Excuse me? Oh, no, I'm sorry.
You're sorry for what?
Why are you sorry?
Because I never called you back after we got disconnected, and I should have called you back. I mean, it was rude of me not to call you back.
We didn't get disconnected.
We didn't?
I hung up on you.
You did?
I'm sorry, I was nervous. And that's why I called, to tell you that I was sorry for hanging up on you.
Well, I was the rude one, not you.
Well, actually, it's not really a clear-cut situation we're dealing with here.
It isn't?
No. You see, I thought we were disconnected, and I still didn't call you back. I was nervous, too.
You did? You were?
Yeah, I got cold feet. You see, I haven't dated in a while, and so, you know, things were... Anyway, I knew you were expecting me to call, and I didn't, so, I'm definitely sorry about that for sure.
It doesn't matter.
No, of course it does.
No, I took the phone off the hook. I thought you were going to call me back, and so I took the phone off the hook so I wouldn't have to speak to you. I had cold feet, too.
No kidding.
No kidding.
Well, guess it's at least one thing we have in common then, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, what do you do?
I work for this company, you know, telecommunications.
Oh, no kidding. Me too.
Really?
Really.
Well.
So I guess that's, you know, two things we have in common then, huh?
Oh. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
So, I guess we should, you know, make a date.
To do what? Oh, right.
Well, yeah, let me see what I have here. No good. Booked. How about the 21st?
I'm on Park Avenue.
Excuse me?
I'm in my car on Park Avenue. See?
Oh.
I don't have my schedule with me. Well, actually, I do have a schedule with me, but it's not my primary schedule, and, well, I'd hate to pencil you in and then get home and check my primary schedule only to find that there was a discrepancy.
I understand.
You do?
Absolutely.
So, I'll get back to you about it then, okay?
Okay.
Right. Well, bye.
Bye.
Hello?
I just spoke to Jerry.
You did, finally. That's great.
No, it isn't. I don't think we have a thing in common.
What are you talking about?
Silences.
Silences?
Heavy, dead, incredibly oppressive silences. Each one more excruciating than the last. It's a bad omen. We're oil and water, Gale. I don't want to go out with him. It's wrong. He's wrong. I haven't got the time. Now I'm supposed to call him back to confirm a date.
You are a bundle of nerves. You know, you need to get out. You work too hard. You need to get laid. When the hell was the last time you got laid?
Barbara? When was the last time you got laid?
Irrelevant.
Apropos.
Last July. Satisfied?
Honest?
Honest.
Who?
Who? You don't know him.
A one-night stand?
I really, you know, I don't like to use that phrase.
Well, come on, Gale, we're best friends.
All right, it was, you know, the guy who came to fix the refrigerator. Happy?
Really?
It relieved a lot of anxiety, Barbara. A lot, I can tell you that.
I don't know what to say.
Call him, Barbara. Call him.
Hello?
Hey, Frank.
Gale, what's up?
Nothing much, just taking a break, cleaning. You?
Not much. Eating popcorn.
Yeah? What brand?
Paul Newman.
Any good?
So-so, it's not my favorite.
Oh. Store deliver the wrong kind?
No, I order it.
Think of it as a way of donating to charity. You know, they give all the profits to charity.
I got the dressing, too. It makes me feel good.
That's because you're a caring person.
Well, I wouldn't go that far. It's not like I don't eat it.
Don't shortchange yourself. You have a good heart. You always had a good heart.
Is everything okay, Gale?
Yeah, fine. Yeah. I better go. I've got to get back to work.
Gale?
Yeah?
Nothing. Never mind.
I miss you, Frank.
I miss you, too.
Maybe we shouldn't have split up.
Well, we didn't exactly split up, Gale. We just sort of faded away from each other.
How long has it been since we've been together?
5 years.
God.
Time flies, huh?
Work can certainly swallow you up if you let it.
And we let it.
Yeah.
Which is generally a good thing. I, you know, like everything else, it has a downside.
Frank, let's promise ourselves that we'll get together. No more excuses. I'll have a party. We'll invite everyone and we'll really do it up. What do you say?
Sounds great.
You up, did I?
No, not at all. I was up. I'm up.
Is it an awkward time? If it's an awkward time, I can call you at a less awkward time.
No, now's a good time. This is a good time. What time is it?
I'm sorry. I woke you up, didn't I?
No, I'm awake, really. I was just, I fell down.
You fell down?
Yes. But, I got up. Now I'm up. That's why I sounded funny, because I fell down and hit my head.
Oh, my God. Are you all right?
I'm fine. No bruises. I'm fine. Who's this?
Jerry.
Jerry. Oh, how are you, Jerry?
I'm so sorry. It's idiotic of me to call you at this hour.
No, really. It's fine, really.
I just wanted to let you know as soon as possible that I'm not going to be able to make it on the 21st. I'm sorry. I was mistaken.
That's too bad. It's going to be hard after that. I'm going away the whole following week on business.
No kidding. That is too bad.
I hate to travel, but I have to sometimes.
Yeah, I hate to travel, too. Could you hold on a minute? That's my call waiting. Hello?
It's a boy! It's a boy! I didn't wake you, did I?
No, I was up.
Oh, it's a boy! Jerry, Denise is having a boy! I'm gonna have a boy, can you believe this?
Martin, that's wonderful. That's really wonderful.
I had to talk to somebody. I know it's late. I hope you don't mind.
No, hold on. Barbara?
Jerry?
It's this friend of mine, Martin. He's a father-to-be, and he just found out he's gonna have a son.
Oh, tell him I said congratulations.
Barbara says congratulations.
Tell her I said thanks.
He says thanks. Well, 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 isn't this something?
Isn't it?
It is.
I feel great.
So do I.
I don't remember the last time I felt so good.
Neither do I.
Hey, say daddy.
What?
I just want to hear how it sounds.
Daddy.
Son.
Daddy.
Son.
Dad.
Son.
Daddy.
Son.
Daddy.
Son.
Daddy.
My son. God, I can't believe this.
This is incredible. Gotta go, Daddy. I'll talk to you tomorrow.
Bye-bye, son.
Barbara?
Jerry?
Look, why don't I give you a call when you get back from your trip and we could, you know, maybe go out or something, huh?
I'd like that.
You would?
Yes.
Great. So, have a nice trip.
Thanks.
Take care.
You too.
Bye.
Bye.
Hello, hello, hello.
Marty?
Yo, Danny! What you say?
Marty Wiener?
The one and only.
You don't do drugs, do you, Marty?
Drugs? No, absolutely not. Never. Are you kidding? I never drink, smoke, or curse either. Hey, God damn it, I left my cigarettes at the bar.
Marty.
Sorry, that was such a perfect setup.
You left yourself wide open. Hey, how are you? Any nausea, cramps, cravings?
Did you call Dr. Brennan?
Yes, I did, as a matter of fact.
And did he tell you?
Yep, he sure did.
So?
Huh?
My baby! Is it gonna be a boy or is it a girl?
Gee, I thought you made me promise not to tell you.
Did I? I don't remember. Whatever. So, what is it?
Denny, you know you made me swear on my mother. And you made it extremely clear how you feel about people who break their promises.
Okay. That certainly sounds like something I'd say, you know? I'm such a character sometimes. But I didn't mean for it to be that much of a promise or anything.
I don't know what to say.
Look, Martin. This is my baby we're talking about here.
God, I feel so conflicted. You know, to tell you the truth, I'm kind of sorry I found out. In hindsight, I've ruined the thrill of the surprise for myself, and I regret that deeply.
Come on, Marty, male or female?
Oh, which would you prefer?
Either. It doesn't matter to me one iota, so long as it's healthy and grows up to be a good, soulful, spiritual, moral, giving human being.
Wow, that's a beautiful attitude.
Yeah, after that, a girl.
A girl?
Why? Is it a boy?
Oh.
Is it a girl? It's a girl? It's a girl! Hey! Miss Liberty, it's a girl! It's a girl!
Hello? Is Gale there?
May I ask who's calling?
Barbara. Barbara Gordon?
May I ask what this is in reference to, Barbara?
Nothing. I'm just a friend.
I'm sorry, honey. Gale passed away.
Don't ask! Don't ask!
It was the most horrible, the most awful. It was... Have you got a minute?
Hello?
Hi. It's Barbara.
Hi. I'm glad you called. Where are you?
My hotel room. I just checked in.
Is it nice? Barbara?
Gale died.
What?
It was a car accident.
Oh, my God.
Half her face is gone.
Excuse me?
Her aunt was very explicit regarding the details. It was sort of difficult to listen to, but I think it made her feel better to talk about it, so I didn't interrupt.
Jesus. I didn't know her very well. I mean, you know, we only talked a couple times. Never met her.
She had a way of speaking that lifted your spirits. Her voice, just the voice, it had a bounce. It made you feel good.
Hello.
Hello, Frank.
Jerry?
I just called to offer my condolences.
What are you talking about?
Don't you know?
What?
Gale passed away.
What?
I'm sorry, I thought you knew. Frank? Frank?
Hello?
Hello. My name is Frank Oliver. I was a friend of Gail's.
And you heard?
Yes. Just.
She was on the phone when it happened. They know because the impact not only snapped her spinal cord, but forced the receiver through her ear canal, severed the sphenoid and the temporal bones, and lodged itself into her brain.
Hello?
Hi, Linda. This is Barbara Gorton. I'm not sure if you remember me.
Sure, you were invited to my party.
That's right. Look, I'm calling to let you know...
I know.
Oh. The funeral's tomorrow. Are you going?
Of course.
You two were close, I know.
We were.
So, I guess I'll see you at the funeral then?
Yeah.
Well, bye.
Bye.
Yeah.
Martin? Not interrupting anything, am I?
No. I'm just reading the latest pregnancy statistics on this medical research bulletin board. Did you know the United States has the highest child mortality rate of any industrialized nation?
Gale died.
Oh my God, that's terrible. Who's Gale?
You know, she's the woman who set Barbara and I up. Though we haven't actually gotten together yet, but we will. And it'll all be thanks to Gale.
Oh, yeah. Oh, God. I'm sorry.
I only spoke to her once. Barely knew her. For some reason, I've been deeply affected by her death. It's crazy.
Hey, don't say that. It's not crazy.
She was so young. I think.
Hello.
I'm sorry, did I wake you? Go back to sleep. Hello?
Martin?
Yes?
Did you just call me?
Barely knew her. It was a friend of a friend's friend. She died.
Oh gosh, I'm sorry.
Hey, you're not still mad at me for telling you it's gonna be a boy, are you?
Oh, no, don't be silly. I thought about it as soon as I hung up.
I couldn't bear the thought of you staying mad at me. There's too much pain in the world. Too much suffering.
Listen. Did you hear it?
I think so. I think I did, yes. What was it?
Our child, Marty. Did you hear its heartbeat?
Yeah. Yeah. At first I thought it was just static on the line, but now that I know what it was.
What do you want to name it, Marty?
Me? You're asking me what I want to name it?
Sure, why not?
Well, I actually have thought about it a little bit. I just didn't want to say anything because I didn't think it was my place.
I would just love to hear your thoughts, Marty. I really would.
Well, since you put it that way, what do you think about Edward?
It's Anglo-Saxon for prosperous guardian.
What, you don't like it?
No, it's a name.
What's wrong with it?
It's just, you know, prosperous guardian. Sounds like, is it special enough? I mean, I want our baby to have a name that's special.
Well, what did you have in mind?
I wasn't really thinking about boys' names much, but, you know, when I was thinking it might be a girl, I was toying with, I don't know, Aphrodite.
Aphrodite?
Why not? What's wrong with Aphrodite?
Nothing. Jesus, it's Greek for goddess of love.
What obviously isn't going to be an Aphrodite, so the question's moot, but I feel the name should be special.
All right, what do you think about Robert?
All right.
Here's another one. Jonathan.
Oh, look at Penley.
Penley?
Look it up.
Look, if you're into peas, there's a bunch of them. I circled one.
Marty, what does Penley mean?
Penley. Old English for enclosed pasture.
Hello?
How are you holding up?
Okay, I guess. Just barely, actually.
Barbara? Do you, want me to hang up?
No. I don't want to be alone. I like the sound of your voice on the line. Jerry?
Yeah?
Would you stay on until I get into bed?
Sure.
Jerry?
Yeah?
Just checking.
Talk to me, Barbara. Tell me what you're doing.
I'm looking through my bag. I need to find something comfortable to wear to bed. I need to get a good night's sleep.
In bed.
That's right. In bed.
I hope I brought something. I was in such a rush when I left. Let's see.
I have a pair of flannel pajamas.
Barbara?
What do you think?
Huh?
About the pajamas.
Pajamas?
Should I take off what I'm wearing and put them on?
I don't know. Is the room chilly?
No, it's, it's quite warm in here, actually. And, a little sticky.
Well, then the, pajamas would be all wrong then, wouldn't they?
You're right. You're absolutely right. So, where do we go from here?
What kind of underwear do you have on?
God, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to.
What? For what? What are you sorry for? I have, let's see. How about a fresh pair of white cotton panties?
That sounds comfortable.
Do you really think so?
Yeah.
You know, it's so extremely warm in here that maybe I'll just sleep naked.
There's an idea.
What about you?
What's the temperature like in your bedroom?
Warm. Very warm. Hot, actually. And humid, too.
Really? You should call your super. Too much moisture is bad for the electronic equipment. Oh, wait a minute. Look what I have here. Why, it's a red silk teddy. I have been looking all over for this. And looky here.
What?
A lollipop.
Hi, Lynn. Gale. I just wanted to tell you that I'm planning a party and... Hello?
Good morning.
Morning.
I didn't wake you, did I?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sorry. You want to go back to sleep?
Mm-mm.
Hello.
Hi, Linda. Frank Oliver.
Hi.
I went to the funeral.
Oh, how was that?
I didn't stay very long.
Yeah, I don't blame you.
I couldn't.
I wanted to go. I mean, I really did want to go, but I've never been to a funeral my whole life, and they're really discouraging. And I don't have a good outlook on life as it is.
You're mourning in your own way. Gale would have understood that.
You think so?
Don't feel bad. Death is... well, it's just not for everyone. I don't know if you know this, but Gale and I were very close.
She was a nice person.
Wasn't she, though?
Her voice bounced. Did you ever notice how her voice bounced, you know?
All the time.
It's a little pushy, though, sometimes, and a little bit of a know-it-all. But I mean, likable pushy, and she really did know a lot, you know? And she cared. She really did care about people. I mean, in her likable, pushy kind of way, she really cared.
She did.
Yeah.
Gale was planning a party. She wanted to get everyone, all her friends, together. It's so hard to get to see everyone. I think we should still do it. You know, sort of in Gale's honor.
In memoriam.
If I plan one, would you come?
Well, I mean, I don't know. You know how it is. But I mean, I just guess it depends on when you would have it. I mean, when do you think you might have that?
I don't know. I'd try to make it a convenient time for everyone. If it was a convenient time, would you come?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah.
Hello?
What are you wearing?
Stop. I just got back.
Is it that red silk blouse? You know, the one that makes you feel immodest?
You're such an animal.
Sorry to meet you at the airport, but I got hung up.
Oh, don't be silly. I told you not to.
But I wanted to.
It wasn't necessary.
But I wanted to anyway.
Don't be silly.
But I wanted to, honest to God. I was determined, but I couldn't, so I'm sorry.
You're so thoughtful.
Ah.
So, did you go to the funeral?
No, but I wanted to very much. I, like I said, I got hung up. I guess this means you didn't go either, huh?
Well, by the time I got back with this and that, and then the next thing, I planned on it, but, well, I was running around like a chicken without its head, and...
All this talk of death, call me depraved, but it's making me wanna, you know, is that all right?
Late at night, and you're sleeping, you'll hear my lonesome call, and you'll feel my waiting lips barely touching you at all. But it's only as real as any dream can seem. I'll see you in your wildest dream. A thousand miles, though I may be now, I'm before you on my knee. But a million miles can't erase the love you have for me. A million miles, it seems, but you can feel my love light beam. I'll see you in your wildest.
And a half hours of microsurgery, and they still couldn't extricate that damn thing.
Even if she had survived, she would have been a vegetable.
She swallowed her tongue. Oh, this is horrible.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think about her constantly. Constantly, every waking minute. I can't get her out of my mind.
Mm-hmm.
I've never felt this way about anyone before. Ever. This is the real thing, Martin. The real thing. Hold on. Hello?
Hi.
Hi. Hold on, I'm on the other line. I'll get off. Martin?
Jerry, I've got Denise on the other line. I think she's going into labor.
Jesus, hold on. Barbara, it's Martin. Denise is in labor.
How far apart are her contractions?
How far apart are her contractions?
How far apart are your contractions?
3 minutes.
3 minutes.
3 minutes.
Oh, my God.
Jesus, God.
Mother of God.
All right, I got a cab. I'm on my way to the hospital.
Which one? Maybe I could meet you.
No, don't get off the line. Just promise me you won't get off the line. Just don't leave me, Marty.
Please don't leave me.
I swear. Hold on a sec. Jerry?
What the hell is going on?
She's in a taxi heading for the hospital.
She's headed for the hospital.
How's she doing?
How are you doing?
She's doing all right.
She's all right.
Who's this?
Barrington Phillips, cab driver. How you doing? Denise, she give me the phone. She tell me to tell you that she's having a private moment. Please stand by.
Tell her I'm here. I'm right here.
She's right here. Are you the father?
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
My wife, she's having a baby too.
Really? Well, congratulations to you.
Thank you. Boy or girl?
Boy. And you?
I don't know. We tell the doctor not to ruin the surprise.
Marty, are you there? Marty?
Denise?
Marty.
Don't worry. I'm right here, Denise.
Hi, Denise. Who's that?
Barbara, a friend of my friend Jerry, who's also on the line.
Hi, Denise.
I arranged to have us all put on conference call. You don't mind, do you, Denny? The other way was so unmanageable, and you told me once you liked meeting new people.
You're so thoughtful, Marty. I hope our son is half as thoughtful.
How are you doing?
All right. I guess!
You just hang in there, Denise.
Hello, Jerry?
Frank?
Frank who?
Who's that?
Frank? Is that you? What are you doing on this line?
I just called you up. What's going on?
I'm on a conference call. How did you get on this line?
I don't know.
Something must be screwed up.
Technology.
I'm sorry. I'll get off.
No, get off. The more people, the better. It's comforting.
Who's that?
That's Denise. She's having Martin's baby.
Martin Wiener?
Hi, Frank.
Hi, Martin. Hi, Denise.
Barbara's on also.
Hi, Frank.
Hello.
Who's that?
Who's this?
Who's this?
Who's that?
This is Dr. Brennan.
Oh, hi, Dr. Brennan. This is Martin Wiener. Remember, we spoke on the phone a couple of weeks ago?
I thought you promised you weren't going to tell her.
This is
highly irregular, Martin, but Denise insists, and... No, you know Denise. And as the hospital hasn't formed a policy yet, I'm going to permit it, but...
Hello?
Hello?
Is this 555-3117?
Linda?
Frank?
Come on.
Push. Okay, good. Yeah. Push.
Thrust! Push!
Don't focus on the pain.
Come on.
Push.
Thrust! Push!
Don't focus on the pain!
Oh, God!
Thrust!
Come on.
Push!
Oh, God! Don't focus on the pain!
Come on!
Push!
Thrust!
Push! Focus on the pain!
It's a girl. A girl?
A girl?
I was wrong. It happens.
A girl?
A girl.
Is a girl?
Yes!
That's wonderful.
Son? Jerry?
I'm upset.
What about?
We've been making love on a very regular basis, and it's been, you know, very fulfilling, spiritually as well as physically, till lately. I've had my suspicions now for some time, and then last night, I'm positive she was faking it.
Oh, are you sure you're not just reading into something that isn't there?
No. The words she chose, and the timing, the inflections, it was so artificial. She was just going through the motions.
Oh, I hate that.
Made me so angry, Martin, so angry. So I just faked it back. You know? I mean, that's the thing about doing it over the phone. There's total equality of the sexes.
Boy, you really sound bitter.
I'm never calling her back, Martin. Never, as long as I live. I don't want to speak to that woman ever again.
Yeah, I know. Hold on. Hello?
Hi, Barbara.
I'm sorry, but I'm on a business call.
Please, it's very important.
I can't, not now.
Frank told me he invited you to his party. Are you going?
I'm not sure.
Please be there.
I don't know.
Please. Please.
Okay.
Good, good. So I'll talk to you then.
Yeah.
Okay, okay. All right then, well, bye.
Bye. That was him again. He calls 3 times a day, he's smothering me.
Man.
He says he just wants to talk.
Yeah, right, yeah, sure.
Whatever happened to romance, that's what I want to know. He was so sweet in the beginning, sending little love faxes all the time.
Yeah, well, now it's moan, groan, dial tone, right?
Last week, I was so embarrassed. Right in the middle, my mom called. I think she knew.
No.
I'm so confused. What do you think I should do?
Well, I don't know. You love him?
I don't know.
Why don't you give it a little rest, you know? Get a little distance from each other.
Hello?
Hi. How are you?
I'm fine.
How's Aphrodite?
Oh, she's good. She loves a rattle you sent.
Does she? Good, I'm glad.
Oh, I called the doctor. He said that it's normal for her bowel movements to be green. You worried, didn't you? I told you not to worry.
No, I wasn't, really.
Marty.
Look, I was thinking. You know, Frank is giving a New Year's Eve party, and he invited me. And at first I said I probably couldn't make it, but then I thought about it. I was wondering if you wanted to go. You could meet me there.
I don't know. When is it?
New Year's Eve. You said you wanted to get together, and I thought that might be a good time.
You're not doing this because you feel pressured, are you? I mean, you don't have to feel pressure. No obligations, remember?
No, no. It's New Year's Eve. I'm making time. In the evening. I'm working during the day.
Are you sure?
Yes. Yes. So, will you come?
Is it all right? All right.
Good.
Thank you. you're sleeping, you'll hear my lonesome call.
The city streets are dark and cold, along the huts about to unfold. The neon lights are flashing by, a stranger's voice is whispering why. We'll never stop, we'll never give in, our fire burns like a violin. We'll keep on playing until the end, a rock and roll will never bend. We're living fast, we're living loud, our hearts are beating like a drumming crowd. We are the rebels, we are the ones. Our music echoes like a thousand guns. We're driving down the open road, our spirits high, our passion glowed. We're chasing dreams that seem so far, we're raising hell like shooting stars. We'll never stop, we'll never give in, our fire burns like a violin. We'll keep on playing, we'll keep on playing until the end, a rock and roll will never bend. We're living fast, we're living loud, our hearts are beating like a drumming crowd. We are the rebels, we are the ones, our music echoes like a thousand guns. We'll never stop, we'll never stop. We'll never stop. We're living fast, we're living loud, our hearts are beating like a drumming crowd. We are the rebels, we are the ones, our music echoes like a thousand guns. Fast, we're living loud, our hearts are beating like a drumming crowd. We are the rebels, we are the ones, our music echoes like a thousand guns.